गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, दिस इज श्याम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम सिविल डिपार्टमेंट। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस एस्टिमेशन स्पेसिफिकेशन एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स लेक्चर 2। टुडे टॉपिक इज अप्रोक्सीमेट एस्टिमेशन प्रॉब्लम्स। प्रीवियसली वी डिस्कस द अप्रोक्सीमेट एस्टिमेशन मेथड्स, सो टुडे विल डिस्कस इन दिस प्रॉब्लम्स। Approximate estimate, three stages. First one is plinth area method and cubical contents method, and third one unit base method. These three methods. First one, plinth area method. The cost of construction is determined by the multiplying plinth area with plinth area rate. The area is obtained by multiplying length and breadth. It is outer side dimensions. In fixing the plinth area rate, careful observations and necessary inquiries are made in respect of quality and quantity, aspect of materials and labor, the type of foundation, height of buildings, roofs, woodworks, pictures, and number of stories, etc. So we go to the plinth area method problem. Already previously we solved the two problems, and next one plinth area method third problem. So write this problem. The plinth area and plinth area rate of a residential building are 100 square meters and 5000 rupees respectively. Determine the total cost of the building assuming suitable provisions. This is the problem. Previously we solved the problems in some data is given in problem, but in this problem assuming the provisions like sanitary, electrification, roads and lands, PS means petty supervision. This is the assumes. Previously there were give in problem. Generally, each provision cost is 7.5%, minimum 5 to 10% taken. So, write the solution and write the given data. Cost of building, we find out mainly. So, cost of the building equal to plinth area multiplying plinth area rate. Plinth area is 100 square meters and plinth area rate is 5000 rupees. So both of multiply 100 into 5000, it is equal to 5 lakhs. So next, one by one assume the data. First here, cost of water supply and sanitary fitting. So here both water supply and sanitary. So each one is 7.5% cost is taken. So totally water supply 7.5 plus sanitary fitting 7.5, so equal to 15%. So here cost of water supply and sanitary fitting at 15% equal to, we are find of the cost of water supply and sanitary fitting formula. Total cost of the building multiplying with cost of water supply and sanitary fitting is 15% divided by 100. So cost of the building is 5 lakhs into cost of the water supply and standard fitting 15 divided by 100. So it is solved 75,000 rupees. Next one, second provision, cost of electric patient is 7.5%, means 7.5%. So cost of the electrification at 7.5% equal to cost of the building multiply with cost of electrification percentage divided by 100. So cost of the building 5 lakhs multiply cost of electrification 7.5 divided by 100 equal solved to final amount 37,500. Next, third provision, cost of roads and lands is 5%. So here is assumed suitable provisions. So you take it 5% or 7.5%. So here 5% taken. So equal to cost of building multiply with cost of roads and lands 5 divided by 100. And solve the amount 25,000. Next, final one, cost of PS. PS means petty supervision and county agencies at 4%. So formula, cost of building and cost of PS divided by 100. 5 lakhs multiply with 4 divided by 100. So equal to 20,000. So totally add the cost of building remaining provisions. So 5 lakhs plus 75,000 plus 37,500 plus 25,000 plus 20,000. This totally added the come to cost of total cost of the building. So here therefore total cost equal to 6,57,500 rupees. It is the plinth area problem. So next one, second method, second problem next. Read the problem. Prepare an approximate estimate of proposed buildings from the following data. So data is plinth area of the building equal to 226 square meter, means 226 square meters, and cost of structure 2500 per square meter. Next, water supply and sanitary arrangements means 12.5%. Next, electrification 7%. Electrification 7%. Next, fluctuation of rates equal to 5%. Next, petty supervision charges equal to 3%. next go to the solution. So first cost of the building. Cost of the building equal to, it is the plinth area method. How to find this plinth area method? We go to the problem and check plinth area method to find the formula plinth area into plinth area rate. Here plinth area building area is given and cost of the structure means plinth area rate. So it is the plinth area problem. So cost of the building equal to plinth area multiply plinth area rate. Plinth area is 226 into plinth area rate 2500. Both multiply 5,65,000. Next, cost of other provisions one by one solved and added finally. First one, water supply and sanitary arrangements is 12.5%. So cost of water supply and sanitary arrangements at 12.5% equal to, here formula is cost of the building multiply with water supply and sanitary arrangement percentage means 12.5%. So here find 100% and solved amount is 70,000. And next provision is electrification in given data 7%. So next write cost of electrification at 7% equal to cost of the building multiply electrification divided by 100. And amount is 39,550 rupees. Next one, we solve the water supply and sanitary arrangements and electrification. Next two provisions we solve. Next one, fluctuation of rates and petty supervision rates. Next, fluctuation of rates at 5% equal to cost of the building multiply with fluctuation of rates. So cost of the building is 5,65,000 and multiply fluctuation rate is 5% divided by 100 equal to, the amount is 28,250. Next, petty supervision charges 3%. Right, cost of petty supervision charges 3% equal to cost of the building multiply petty supervision charges 3 divided by 100 equal to 16,950 means 950 rupees. So we solve the all cost of provisions. So here next total cost of the building, totally provisions and cost of building are added or summed. So here last final step, therefore total cost of the building equal to 5,65,000 plus 70,000 plus 39,550 plus 28,250 plus 16,950. टोटली सम 7,19,750 रुपीज़। तो कॉस्ट ऑफ द बिल्डिंग, टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ द बिल्डिंग 7,19,750। दिस इज द पिंक एरिया मेथड प्रॉब्लम। नेक्स्ट सेकंड मेथड, क्यूबिकल कंटेंट मेथड। This method is generally used for multi-storied buildings. It is more accurate than the other two methods. That's methods plinth area method and unit base method. The cost of structure is calculated approximately as the total cubical contents. Cubical contents means volume of the building. Multiply by local cubic rate. Volume means length, breadth, and height or depth. So the volume of the building is obtained by the length multiplied breadth multiplied depth or height. The length and breadth are measured out to outer wall including the plinth offset. So cubical content method, the formula is cost of the building equal to volume of buildings multiply with rates divided by unit volume. This is the cubical content method formula. So we go to the problem in cubical content method. Write the problem. Prepare the rough estimate for proposed the commercial complexes for the commercial complex for Municipal Corporation for the following data. Municipal Corporation for the following data. In this problem, some data is given. Right. First one, plinth area equal to plinth area equal to 500 square meters per floor. Next one, height of the each story 3.5 meters. Next one, number of stories equal to G plus 2. Next, cubical content rate equal to 1000 rupees per cubic meter. Next, provide the following as a percentage of structure to cost. First one, water supply and sanitary arrangement 8%. Next, second one, electrification 6%. Next, fluctuation of rates 5%. Next, contractor profit 10%. Petty supervision and contingencies 3%. So this is the problem. This problem, how to find it, which method? So first one, plinth area method is in given data, plinth area and plinth area rate. But in this problem, plinth area and height of the each story. height of the each story means HR, height or depth. So area into height is equal to volume. So it is method is cubical content method. So next go to the solution. Cubical content formula is length into breadth into height. Already in this problem is given plinth area. Area into height is equal to volume, means cubical content. So equal to plinth area is 500 and height of the each story 3.5. Here totally number of stories 3. So multiply with number of stories. Total cost of height and volume of the building total. So plinth area is 500 and height of the each story is 3.5. It is the each one floor, but here totally G plus 2, 3 floors. Number of stories means 3. 3 into 500 into 3.5 equal to 5250 cubic meters. It is the cubical content. Next is structural cost. Cubical content multiply with cubical content rate. So total cubical content is 5250 multiply content rate is already we give the problem. Cubical content rate is 1000 per cubic meter. So 1000 multiply equal to 52 lakhs 50,000. This is the structural cost of the building. Next, other provisions. First one, water supply and sanitation. First, water supply and sanitary arrangement 8%. So formula equal to total cost of the building multiply with water supply and sanitary arrangement is 8%. 8 divided by 100 equal to 4,20,000, means 4.2 lakh. Next, second one, electrification. Electrification is 6%. So equal to cost, total cost of the building is 2.5 lakhs. Multiply with 6% divided by 100. So electrification cost is 3.15 lakhs. Means 3,15,000. Next, third one. Fluctuation rates 5%. Fluctuation of rates equal to total cost of building is 52,50,000, means 52.5 lakhs. Multiply with 5% divided by 100 equal to 2,62,000. So total added $9.975. 3 added provisions 4.2 lakhs, 3.15 lakhs, 2.62 lakhs. So 9.975. So building cost 52,50,000. So total is 62.47 lakhs. Next, other provisions, contract profit and petty supplement. This is the total
cost of the building is taken is to profit, not a scrub. Not the structural cost not taken, and other provisions added and take the contract properties added and petty supervision. So next one, petty supervision and contingency is 62,47,000 multiplied with petty supervision percentage is 3 divided by 100. It is 1,87,000. Next, final one, contractor profit. Contractor profit, total cost of the project in 10% taken every project. So contractor profit is taken, total cost of the project is 62.475 multiply with 10% divided by 100, 6,24,000. Next, total cost of the project is total added. Already added, total cost is 62,47,000 and plus add petty supervision plus contract profit. So 62 lakhs, 1,87,000, next 6,24,000, both added. The total cost of the structure is 70,59,000. 70.69 lakhs. This is the cubical content method. Next, third method is unit based method. According to this method, the cost of structure is determined by multiplying the total number of units with unit rate of each item. In case schools and colleges, the unit considered to be one student. And in case of hospital, the unit is one bed. The unit rate is calculated by dividing the actual expenditure incurred or cost of similar building in the nearby locality by the number of units. So here, unit-based method is used mainly commercial structures like school buildings and colleges, hospitals, etc. So unit-based method is go to the problem, third method. Right problem. Prepare an approximate estimate or rough cost estimate of hospital building for 50 beds. The cost of construction altogether for each bed is 60,000 rupees. Determine the total cost of hospital building. So here is third method is only given numbers and each number amount. So multiply with total cost of the project. Here hospital building is given. In this number of beds, 50 beds is given. And each bed cost is 60,000. Each bed means not bed. Each bed construction altogether for each bed. So solution and given data right. Here number of beds equal to 50. Next, cost of construction for each bed equal to 60,000 rupees. Here we find the total cost of hospital building. Here therefore total cost of hospital building equal to number of beds multiplying the cost of construction of each bed. So number of beds is 50, and each cost of the construction each bed is 60,000. 50 into 60,000 equal to 30 lakhs. It is the total cost of the hospital building. So next problem. To prepare the rough cost estimate of a hostel building which accommodate 150 students, the cost of construction including all provisions is 15,000 per student. Determine the total cost of the building. Here also, how many numbers and how many numbers each cost is given. So here determine the total cost of the building. Here is given hostel building. So solution given data is number of students equal to, here number of students 150 students, and cost of construction is per student 15,000. So here determine the total cost of the building. So number of students equal to 150. Next one, cost of construction including all LS provisions. Equal to 15,000. Next, total cost of hostel building equal to number of students multiply with cost of construction per student is 15,000. Both are multiplied. So 150 into 15,000 equal to 22,50,000. This is the hostel building for total cost. So this is the third method. So first one is plinth area method, and second one is cubical content method, and third one finally is unit based method. This is three methods. Any doubt for anyone? So thank you. Okay, thank you very much. I love it.